Hello and welcome. You are logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I am Sangram Singh Rathore and today's headlines are: In India, the UIDAI has warned people against sharing their Aadhaar number and the Supreme Court has asked authorities to not take any coercive action over Assam's NRC draft. In America, North Korea is reportedly working on new missiles and US has returned all unselected H-1B visa petitions. In Punjab, CM Amrinder Singh has blamed drug fear over youth going abroad and Lok Insaf Party MLA Simarjeet Singh Bais has taken a jibe at Aam Aadmi Party Chief Arvind Kejriwal. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: The UIDAI has asked people not to share publicly their 12-digit identifier on the internet and social media or post such challenges to others. This advisory has come with reference to some news items appearing on social media reporting few people publicly posting their Aadhaar number on internet and social media and posing challenges to others. The Supreme Court has said that there will be no coercive action by authorities against over 40 lakh people whose names do not figure in Assam's National Register of Citizens. It observed that it was merely a draft. Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf is considering inviting the leaders of the SAARC countries, including PM Narendra Modi, to its oath-taking ceremony as the premier next month. Khan has emerged as the single largest party in the National Assembly after the July 25th election. The central government has said that the population of all illegal Rohingya immigrants in the country was being identified and once that is done, they will be deported back to Myanmar. States have also been asked to carry out enumeration of such people and also collect their biometric details. The Supreme Court has dismissed a plea seeking review of its April 19th verdict that had held that special CBI judge B.H. Loya had died of natural causes on December 1, 2014. It rejected PIL seeking an SIT probe into the death, questioning their motive. A UK court has asked Indian authorities to submit within 3 weeks a video of a cell at the Arthur Road jail in Mumbai. This is where absconding liquor baron Vijay Mallya will be housed post-extradition. It set a September 12th deadline for closing arguments in his high-profile extradition trial. Kurukshetra University is likely to lose a central grant of Rs 100 crore on account of low strength of regular teachers on its rolls. The availability of 70% regular teachers in all teaching departments was a key prerequisite to get special financial aid announced by the MHRD. Subsidized cooking gas price has been hiked by Rs 1.76 per cylinder due to tax impact on the change in base price. The government, however, subsidizes 12 cylinders of 14.2 kg each per households in a year by providing the subsidy amount directly in bank accounts of users. Saina Nehwal and Kidambi Srikanth won their opening matches at the World Championships in straight games to advance to the third and second round respectively in China on Tuesday. Sai Praneet also moved to the second round after South Korea's Son Won-ho withdrew from the tournament with an injury. Bollywood singer Mika Singh has lodged a complaint of theft of cash and jewellery worth about Rs 3 lakh at his home in Mumbai. Based on the complaint, the police have registered an offence against a piano artist and associate of Singh who was working with him since many years. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: Spy agencies have reported that North Korea was constructing new missiles at a factory that produced Pyongyang's first intercontinental ballistic missiles capable of reaching the US. Newly obtained evidence, including satellite photos, indicates that work is underway at a research facility near Pyongyang. The US Citizenship and Immigration Services had returned all the petitions of H-1B visas popular among Indian IT professionals that were not selected in April for the fiscal year of 2019. Tech companies depend on H-1B visas to hire tens of thousands of employees each year. President Donald Trump is ready to meet the Iranian leadership without any precondition anytime Tehran wants to. Trump recently slashed down on Iran on Twitter in response to Iranian President Hossein Rouhani's threats against the US. President Donald Trump has said that he was looking into whether Americans should be able to print their own guns. 8 US states have filed a lawsuit to block a Trump administration decision enabling 3D printers to make plastic handguns. China has urged the US not to allow Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen to transit its territory when she visits Belize and Paraguay next month. While the US has no formal ties with Taiwan, it is the island's main source of arms and strongest unofficial diplomatic backer. The number of people ordered to flee from two Northern California wildfires has swelled to 15,000. Firefighters are hopeful that the state's largest and deadliest blaze of the year was slowing down after days of explosive growth. California's fiery anti-war activist and former congressman Ron Dellums has died from cancer, aged 82. The first black congressman of Northern California was at the center of most major liberal movements of the 1970s and 1980s. Dellums was elected as mayor of his native Oakland in 2006. The US and Pakistan have agreed to restore their bilateral relationship during a meeting between Defense Secretary James Mattis and Islamabad's ambassador in America, Ali Jahangir. The White House had suspended its $225 million military aid to Pakistan earlier this year. Facebook has taken down fake accounts after it uncovered sophisticated attempts at political influence ahead of the US midterm elections. The fake accounts and pages taken down were linked to Russia's Internet Research Agency and were involved in coordinated inauthentic behavior. Actress Priyanka Chopra will play the love interest of Chris Pratt in Cowboy Ninja Viking. The film is directed by Game of Thrones fame Michael McLaren. Priyanka recently appeared in A Kid Like Jake opposite James Parsons and Claire Danes. I'll be back. Stay locked down to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: CM Amrinder Singh has claimed that drug problem in educational institutes is one of the biggest reasons why parents are sending their children abroad. Singh was addressing an anti-drug campaign launched by a committee of unaided colleges. Lok Insaf Party founder Simarjeet Singh Bains has taken a jibe at Aam Aadmi Party convener Arvind Kejriwal for accusing him of insulting a Dalit MLA Harpal Cheema. Bains has accused Kejriwal of trying to create caste tensions by twisting his remark against Cheema. The state has approved restoration of 14% reservation for SC employees for filling vacancies by promotion. This has been done in light of a Supreme Court ruling regarding SC reservation. The Aam Aadmi Party has unanimously approved appointment of MLA Harpal Cheema as leader of the opposition. State and national leadership of Aam Aadmi Party has also disassociated itself from the August 2nd convention called by SAC leader of opposition Sukhpal Khera-led group of rebel MLA. Congress MP Santokh Singh Chaudhary has asked the centre to complete National Highway 1 project as early as possible so that people get relief from chronic traffic congestions. Chaudhary was raising the issue of long-pending under-construction bridges on the Jalandhar-Panipat Expressway. CM Amrinder Singh has announced a grant of Rs 50 lakh for the construction of a Gurdwara and Guru Nanak school damaged in the recent violence at Shillong. Singh also assured a delegation of all possible assistance for the Sikh community settled in Meghalaya. Aam Aadmi Party MLA Sukhpal Singh Khera has claimed that the popular sentiment in party's Punjab unit is with him. Khera is confident of getting the support of 15 out of 20 Aam Aadmi Party MLAs. However, Khera claims that he does not want a split party but rather wants to reunite it. State Cabinet has approved Punjab Laws Bill amid concerns raised by local bodies minister Navjot Singh Sidhu. The bill is a special provision for regularization of unauthorized colony. Sidhu had objected the policy being allowed on the basis of saleable, not the built-up area of colony. Barnala Deputy Commissioner Dharampal Gupta has met Asian Games gold medalist athlete Hakam Singh Bhattal, who is suffering from liver and kidney ailments. Bhattal is currently admitted to a private hospital in Sangrur. He is also a Dhyan Chand Award winner. Singer Jashan Singh, known for singing Punjabi songs like Zakhmi and Ik Yaad Purani, is set to release a single titled Pagalpan. It is dedicated to those crazily in love. The song will be sung in mixed Punjabi and Hindi languages. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Actor Akshay Kumar, to a query whether he feels that his film Gold can generate interest for sports in the minds of audiences and help India to become a better sports nation, said,
"Mujhe kahani achhi lagi. Mujhe lagi ki ye kahani ko batana chahiye. And I must tell you guys, this is a badi dilchasp kahani hai Gold ki aur asli kahani hai. Hum bahut sare panne ho jate hain jo ekdam history ke niche pad jate hain aur ekdam us pe dhool mitti pad jati hai, kisi ko pata hi nahi chalta. Aaj tak मुझे भी नहीं पता था और मैंने कई मीडिया लोगों को पूछा है, किसी को नहीं पता था कि पहला गोल्ड ओलंपिक गोल्ड मेडल हिंदुस्तान को 1948 में मिला था। कैसे मिला था, किसके लिए मिला था, क्यों मिला था, उसके लिए क्या 1947 में जब ब्रिटिश हमको छोड़ के गई थी 200 साल बाद, हमने कैसे एक पूरे 11 मेंबर की टीम इकट्ठी की, उसको प्रैक्टिस करवाया और लेके गए और गोल्ड मेडल जीत के लाए, वो भी इंग्लैंड में जाके इंग्लैंड को हरा के फाइनल्स में। सो दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स इज दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आई थिंक मिस्टर सिनेमा कैन शो इन अ वेरी नाइस वे इन अ बिकॉज अगर इसी को हम डॉक्यूमेंट्री में बना ले तो शायद कोई देखे ही नहीं, लेकिन उसके अंदर कोई 4-5 गाने डाल दे, एक दो फाइट डाल दे, हीरोइन आ जाए, हीरो आ जाए, तो ये सब कुछ बड़ा दिलचस्प लगता है।
Directed by Reema Khatki, a historical sports drama inspired by India's first Olympic gold medal, releases on August 15th. Anil Kapoor, Aishwarya Rai Bachchan and Rajkumar Rao, star of film Fane Khan, is giving hit songs one after another. And today, they released another song titled Badan Pe Sitare. On Mohammed Rafi's 38th death anniversary on Tuesday, actor Anil Kapoor unveiled the recreated version of the iconic song Badan Pe Sitare, sung by Sonu Nigam. Sharing the rehashed version on Twitter, Anil wrote, "Honoring and remembering Mohammed Rafi Saab on his death anniversary with this small tribute. We can never match up to his talent, but this is just our way of showing our love for him. Badan Pe Sitare." The song sees Kapoor as the lead vocalist to his band Jhankar Orchestra performing on the stage. Fane Khan is a Hindi adaptation of the Dutch film Everybody's Famous. Co-produced by Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra and directed by Atul Manjrekar, the film also features Aishwarya Rai Bachchan, Divya Dutta and Rajkumar Rao, with Pihu San playing a key role. The film is about an aspiring singer. The original song, picturized on actress Vijayanti Mala and late veteran actor Shami Kapoor, featured in the 1969 film Prince. Its new version finds a place in Anil Kapoor's starrer, Fane Khan. Fane Khan releases on the 3rd August.